There's a red fence behind my house, just beyond my back porch where I sit some mornings. Pencil and eraser in hand, playing word games on the daily paper. In my favorite, a single player is given a starting word and an ending word and must transfer and form the first into the second, one letter at a time. But I digress. I glance from time to time to where piles of gutted vegetation are evidence of last month's relentless machines. Machines that cut and slash like slow motion metal ninja warriors until a road was revealed. Worn tarmac and faded paint, once hidden by a symphony of green limbs, bending in synchrony with the gentle breeze. Now a thinly clad forest of starved vegetables can hide nothing, least of all their own near nakedness. The fence, a crude construct of waste wood and rusted, twisted wire, hides virtually nothing of the chaos chiseled in mud these last few weeks. It feebly warns passing drivers of a half-drained pond and a profusion of pipes and trenches, dirt and ramps, stained red plastic flags, marking more woods awaiting destruction. I gape with fear and confusion, trapped in an impossible word game. How can I make forward from backward? How do I make peace from conflict? Finally, a course of red fence, condemned trees, and worried narrator. Ask the ultimate question, how to make progress from destruction.